I mean, we had some bad connection, but we are back again. And I hope that Anshuman will join us back again. This is Sridhar Rangayan, the festival director of Kashish Mumbai International Queer Film Festival, which is going to have its 12th edition, which is going to be happening from August 19th to September 5th. The festival was supposed to be scheduled from May 20th to June 6th, but it's been rescheduled because of the current pandemic situation. And so it's going to happen from August 19th to June 5th. So please join us at Kashish 2021. It's going to be an online edition totally. And you can go to mumbaiqueerfest.com and try to find the attend tab there and register there. So thank you all for joining in back again. And we're going to be having Anshuman Das coming back soon again to talk about his amazing film, Hum Bhi Akele, Tum Bhi Akele, which is the closing film of Kashish 2020 Virtual, which was held in July 2020. So we are waiting for Anshuman Jha to come back soon. And we're going to have this wonderful conversation with this brilliant actor. The film is amazing. I just love the film. And that's the reason we programmed it as a closing film. With him, and I hope everything, all the technical details are sorted out this time. Hi, Anshuman. Good to hope to have you here with us.
Having third time, Lata.
Yes, perfect. We are perfect now.
Good, good. How are you, sir? So good to see you.
I'm totally fine. Locked in, of course, in Mumbai. Where are you?
I am at home in Bombay. This is the new normal, doing interviews online for the last 6 hours. But we are just very grateful. You were one of the first people to see the film, so I was overtly keen to do this chat with you so that get your blessings and just very happy that the film is finally coming out.
Yeah, I know. It's been a fantastic journey for you. The film has played at many film festivals, won a couple of awards and special mentions. So congratulations on that journey. And so tell us a little bit about the film before, I mean, I think most of the viewers might not have, they must have seen the trailer, but tell us a little bit and whatever you want to reveal, don't reveal too much maybe, I don't know.
Well, Hum Bhi Akele, I'll quickly tell you a recap of the journey. Harish Vyas and me did a film. Harish Vyas is the filmmaker. He made a film called Angrezi Mein Kehte Hain, which is on Amazon Prime, which had Sanjay Mishra, me and Pankaj Tripathi. The world premiere of that film, we went to New York and he had, in the car drive, the taxi drive from JFK to New Yorker, he was very quiet. He's not the quiet sort of man usually. So I said, what's up? And he said, I've been thinking of this story which I really want to tell. And he has a best friend from college called Supnu, who's gay. And Harish sir didn't know that he's gay for 3 years after they left college. So basically they had spent their whole college life together. And Harish sir knew that one of his closest friends is a homosexual. So I have this, he's my reference and I'm trying to write a story about a boy and a girl on a road trip. And will you do it? Will you play a homosexual character? I said, I would love to, because if we write it well, give it time. And that's how the journey began. So it was in a taxi. And then it took a year of writing, rewriting. Then the film was at the South Asian Film Market in Singapore as one of the top 10 strips from Asia. Then we finished the film. It premiered in New York again. That's a circle of life, that the taxi drive in New York led to a world premiere in New York. It won the best film there. Then we went to Rajasthan. Then we came to Kashish. Then we went to IFFF. We were going to release last June, which is the Pride month. But because of the lockdown, we lost the theatrical partners. And we are just grateful that now we finally got our...
So yeah, great. So I'm really happy for the journey you have had, and it's an eventful journey. But tell me, how challenging was it for you to play a gay man? You know, did you have to prepare for the role? So what kind of preparation went into you creating this particular character?
So I'll be very honest. This is the most challenging role of my life, hands down, from a prep point of view. Because for me, the psychophysical aspect was the challenge. Because I wanted to be responsible, I wanted to be sensitive. And a lot of people say, hey, when you play a serial killer, it's the same thing. You are not a serial killer, but you play it. But they don't understand that there is an animalistic instinct in each human being. So what you need to do is amplify it and then act. Correct? Here, I had to react to a touch of a man in a manner which is not my first calling. Correct? So that requires a certain kind of mental shift. So it sounds silly, but I did little things like Anshuman wears the watch in the right hand. For we in Hum Bhi Akele Tum Bhi Akele, I started wearing the watch in the left. Something else followed that. I never wear loafers. I requested the costume designer Mandira Shukla, who's the soul of Veer because of the way she styled him and helped me get into the character. She only gave him those, those slip-on kind of comfy leather shoes. So we did these little things. And then, of course, I observed a lot of... I have had friends in the family who are from the community. So earlier, I would just meet them. I started meeting them and observing them. And I realized, like, all human beings, and it's not about being homosexual or heterosexual or bisexual, each one of us is unique in their own way, right? So at some point, I realized that I need to stay honest to the emotion of the character and the conflict he's facing, and it's a major conflict what he has, the fact that he can't come out in front of his own family and his own father, the fact that he has a boyfriend who's not willing to, accept him publicly, which are real issues which people face. So the idea was to stay true to that human emotion. The fact that he happens to be homosexual was not the focus. The focus was to be human, because at the end of the day, we are all human beings and we are all suffering from the same challenges and troubles and conflicts. The problem comes when people start doing they and us. So the idea of the film is that there is no they. Everything is us. We need to accept us and we need to look at everything from a point of humanity. Just not create these barriers. And so from a preparation point of view, that was the workshopping. And then Vinod Rawat, who's from FTII, he's a brilliant acting guy. He spent a week with me and completely stripped me down from every mental thought I had and took me to zero. That was very helpful. From there, I created Veer honestly. And one conscious thing we did was not to caricaturize him, because Bollywood has done that so much. That we wanted to stay away from that. We wanted to keep him human. Yeah.
So in fact, what comes across with the character of Veer is like he's not your typical gay character whom you've seen on screen. Of course, yeah. You've seen these people around you, but you never perhaps labeled them as gay. You don't even know they were gay because they're just like anybody else. And that what came up with the Veer character. It was so normalized, the gay portrayal, and absolutely no. We understand that some gay men are effeminate, but not all gay men have to be effeminate. Exactly. So, exactly. But I think your little touches about the way he walks, he talks, everything was fantastic, Yeah.
Rohini is asking, were you ever afraid about not getting the right note
for me? Not for me.
Right note? Do you mean the sur?
Sur of the character.
I called Ro, Ravishing Ro. She's been ravishing since senior college. Once the prep is done, once I have figured out the... I read the script 50 to 60 times before full parts. And then once I've got the tonality of the sur of the character, so to speak, then I sketch everything around that. So no, I was very cautious of not being irresponsible. Therefore, I checked on the script level. We had people from the community coming in and saying, possible, not possible. You guys are pushing your luck a little bit. This, don't do it. So from that responsibility point of view, yeah, we were very cautious. But otherwise, it was challenging, but it was a lot of fun. This is the best, as an artist, it's the best. In New York, there was a person from the community who gave me a thing, and he has issues with his father. So he said, I felt like you're playing out my story. And that was a big... weight off my chest, because I realized that he's connected to people that working for the community, and that was a big thing.
And you basically added double trouble to your script. You not only had a gay man, but you had a lesbian woman in the script. That is like two things which are like too complicated. Usually you just have a film about a gay man, or you have a film about a lesbian woman. And here you have a gay man and a lesbian woman
going on a road trip. So it is really a very complicated thing, but you people carried off really well. Were you worried that like the entire focus could shift more on Zareen's character and not stay with you, because you're also did that ever bother you ever?
No, I do understand you. I have come from a place of education. Teachers have drilled the craft in me in a manner that I am not insecure about these things ever. In fact, I'm happier if the other people see, as long as the film benefits, I am happy. That's all that, because the film is bigger than all of us. That's an understanding I had when I was very young. So no, I didn't. It was very interesting, in fact, to have somebody like Zareen, who comes from a very different school, a very different process, a very different kind and style of acting. We are polar opposites. But that, consciously, I'll tell you, after she auditioned and got the part, kind of recently discovered, might just create magic. Because sometimes when extreme musicians do Jugalbandi together, good sounds and new sounds, the same as the different schools clash. And I think that element you can see in the trailer also, because essentially the film is about friendship. And human universe, it doesn't matter whether you're gay, whether you're everybody has friends. So I think on that level we really connected and we just jammed, and she flew. Also because I think her real character as Zareen and Monty's are very similar. So what happened was, she took it off from there and we let her fly, because my character was the subdued and the subtle and the undertone one. So, yeah.
Yeah, there are two questions for you. What is your mother tongue, Anshuman?
Maithili. Hum Maithili mein bache chhe. Hamar matribhasha Maithili chhe, which is very close to Bengali.
Okay, that's one of the questions. And Rohini again asking, Anshuman, your personal journey is so interesting to follow on Instagram. How does it help in this profession where stresses are given?
Rohini, I don't take stress, yaar. I think all this Instagram, Facebook, I'm sorry we are doing an Instagram live and I'm saying this. I think it's a lot of bullshit. I think artists don't need followers. Mr. Nasiruddin Shah has 50,000 followers and he's the best actor in India, hands down. And when he's not on screen, we all miss him. There are plenty of actors with 10 million, 20 million followers, and we'll not miss any of it, nor do we meet them now. So I think creating social media with art and craft is a very, it's the truth. I accept it. It's part of the business. Great. But I don't think it's a gauge of one person's, when you're young, maybe it can affect you. But luckily, again, I go back to the teachers. My teachers were very positive. They called out rubbish. And I do the same. So I think we choose the stress. See, our mind is like sponge. I always say this. If you soak sponge in what? If you soak sponge in goodness, goodness will come out. And I surround myself with goodness. So on a worst day also, if you squeeze me, something good will come out. I will not be bitter or negative or any of that. I mean, this pandemic is teaching us. Nothing is happening to us.
Yeah, I remember when we are screening your film, you are traveling from India to US and all kinds of things were happening, but you stayed calm totally. I remember that.
Yeah, I got engaged on that trip. She's here. In fact, Sierra's just flown in. She's flown to India. Imagine the customer was asking, oh, what the hell are you doing here? And she was like, my fiance lives in this country. And like, and you know, they were amazed that they assumed that probably she being an American, situated here. But I told her that she said, you're going to get married to Masaram. Maybe that would have made them a little, they would have seen the fun in it. So she's here. She was there for the world premiere in New York. So it's supposed to happen for the premiere, for the release now, which is, yeah. She's very grateful there.
Okay. We are all, so Rohini asked me, why did we choose the film, your film, to be the closing film at Kashish? Because it's one of the most sensitive films being made on an LGBTQ subject. And here it touches about a lesbian character and also a gay character. And also mainly the family. I mean, that plays out. And these two are great friends. I mean, the Veer and the character of Zareen Khan, basically had two amazing friends who go on a road trip. and they have their differences, but they also have their commonness. And it's a beautiful story which explores so many dimensions of the LGBTQ community and their parents and the how the society treats them. So, and we always love to close or open with Indian film. And this was a boon to us that like an Indian film of wonderful creation was the closing film. So thank you for allowing us to close Kashish 2020 with your film. This year, basically, I think we're going to be showing two feature-length films from India. So hang in there till the Kashish 2021 has been rescheduled to August 19th to September 5th. It was supposed to happen in May, but it's been rescheduled. So, but hang in there. We're going to bring you some 200 awesome films from all over the world, including India, of course. Anshuman, like, I mean, one of the things was how has the family played out in the film? Family is such a crucial part for not just anybody else, but like particularly for LGBTQ community, because families find it very difficult to accept their gay son or a lesbian daughter. And you place family at the center of the entire drama. So how was it, you know, for you?
So again, credit to the writers, Harish Vyas and Susan Fernandez. On the writing table, we were very conscious that we are telling an Indian story. So we have to keep the Indian context in mind. And in India, there are a lot of people, even though it's like now and the landmark Supreme Court verdict happened, and it's going to be 3 years in September this year, I think. So given that also, there is still a lot of taboo, right? There are people who don't want to openly talk about it or discuss it. There are people who can't go back, who are leading dual lives. Like in Bombay, they'll be leading a life, and then back in small towns, they'll pretend like they're something else. So the conscious decision to keep the human element, which these individuals suffer when they go back home with their family, because it's unfair for anybody to be leading that sort of a dual, which is why we incorporated the family for both the characters, for Mansi and for Veer. And I just feel, given the Indian context of the film, like JDK and Achara Kirk reviewed the trailer, and I think in their face, reviewing it from LA, versus Indian season. Because see, the socio-cultural upbringing matters so much. They have grown up with the freedom of equality. We have just started to accept. So there is a difference in how much we ask. But I think right now there is a lot to learn, that something will take time, and keeping the family in the loop, the story was important, so that hopefully after this film, that's why I'm so excited that it's on Disney Plus Hotstar VIP, because I think the perfect platform, it was the platform I wanted the film to be on, because it has the reach. And I hope families can have conversations after this, because you know, in the film, that's what we are trying to encourage. Acceptance.
Yeah. So a lot of people have been asking, these are the questions coming up. When is Mastaram 2 happening? This away from the film we are promoting right now, but they're very keen to know about when is Mastaram 2 happening.
Yeah, Mastaram 2 will happen when the intimacy crew from LA and Canada will fly to India, because I will not be without them. So very, the pandemic has kind of struck all of us. And we just have to wait for flight and air travel and vaccines to be in place for everyone, so that Amanda and Megan can come down and we can shoot again.
Fine. So what is your next project? What is it looking like? I mean, I know that, have you already shot some project which is still being edited and is going to be releasing soon or something?
So, sir, there's a film called Midnight Delhi, which is a beautiful film. It's about one night in Delhi, and the censors have had it for a year. So whenever that gets passed, it will really, I think that means have a story with the censors every beginning. So that's great. There is a web show which I just shot in Arunachal. Luckily, we came back in time. We returned from Arunachal. It's a very exciting travel-based web series about boys and girls. About the boy's past, present, and future, which is basically three women in the car with him. So it's a very unique concept about, how do I put it? It's a fiction show in a real setup. So we shot it in the middle of the plant Arunachal, right? It was a 2,000 kilometer drive done by 50 cars together across Arunachal. And Harish sir and me are doing another film together. So that will be our third together after Angrezi Nikalte Hain and Hum Bhi Akele. So that goes on tour as soon as the pandemic gets over.
Okay, and how do you keep yourself fit and so bright and youthful? What is the secret of your health and vivacity per se, you know?
Sir, sachi batao, will you do it? I sleep on time. I don't drink and I don't sleep. It's actually that simple.
That's all. Wow, that's awesome. So Rohini wants to ask you about this. I mean, tell us, why is this story important to be out there? Are you happy about the OTT release? And where can one watch it?
Well, I'm very happy about the fact that it's on Disney Plus Hotstar VIP. It's part of their multiplex release. They have had phenomenal content like last year, and I think The Big Bull came this year last month. So it's part of the Disney Plus Hotstar multiplex premiere, and please watch it on the 9th of May. And sorry, sir, what was the first part of that question? There were two parts to that question. Where can we watch the Disney Plus Hotstar VIP? And I'm very happy when and, you know, in what state cinema will it. I am a classical cinema lover, so I like watching the big films. But mujhe nahi lagta ki things will normalize for a while. And I think psychology says 21 days takes for a mental habit to change. And people have been locked in for over a year. So I think habits have changed. And footfalls in theater will take a while. For me, this going out, starting conversations is more important than where.
So, yeah, that's true.
And I think Disney Plus Hotstar is the perfect platform for a film like this. And I'm very glad. The songs are picking up really well. Zee Music is really phenomenal. I'm really grateful for all the support that has happened. And you know, Mr. Subramanian has told me every film has its destiny. And I think this film had this destiny and it's now reaching its shore. And I just hope everybody watches it from the 9th of May onwards. And the best is the weekend, right? You can just watch it at your own space and time. So please watch
right.
It. We would love to know what you think of it. 9th of May, Disney Plus Hotstar VIP.
And did you actually submit it to the censor board? I mean, did you have the film censored? And what are the reactions? And what certification did you get? Did they ask you to chop off something? You know.
So that was the... You're opening a can of worms. So we submitted the film last March. And they saw it. And they called me and they gave it an A certificate. And I asked them why. Because there was another film recently called Shubh Mangal Zyada Savdhan, which had two men ki thing, and that had got a UA certificate, and that's great. But you know, in our film, there is nothing. Like, there is not even a peck on the cheek. Forget about... So I asked them genuinely why, and they said, because it's a very well-made film and it will make people think, and we don't want people to think. So I didn't know how to counter that. So I said, now it's been legalized, and what's the harm if people... And yeah, so then I realized I can't have a conversation there. So we sent it back to the revising committee on the 3rd of March. We did not want any because we were coming in theaters at that time. The studio was bringing it to theaters. And then, you know, in March what happened, the 27th was our screening, the revising committee, and the 24th lockdown happened last year. And then we were in a limbo because then we didn't know when the certification would happen. And obviously we can't come in theaters. No, you know how the process is. So we were waiting, and luckily we had Kashish in Dubai, we had IFFM, the closing night film at, the centerpiece film at IFFM and Australia. So though these festivals have really been a pillar because it's kept us going, it's also given us motivation and feedback in terms of what's working, what's not working. We finally got the certification in December. The Censor Office opened in November last year. December is when we got the certificate, and because now we don't think waiting for the theater makes sense anymore.
Right. So a lot of people are saying, hello, hi, shout out my name, sir, etc., etc. So I'm not going to read out some of those things. But if you wish to, you can scroll out and shout out some names if you wish to.
Hi, Rajput. Gaurav Thakur, sir, I can't scroll down on the comments for some. Oh, there you go.
Okay, you can't. Okay, that's fine.
I can. Love the director, Duro. Thank you, Ashin Arora. If you enjoyed Angrezi Mein Kehte Hain, please watch Humbi Akele 9th May on Disney Plus Hotstar VIP. Hi, Ranveer. Hi, Danish. Arey, Sushil sir, you are here. Sushil Dahiya is a fantastic actor. He's a part of the film. And he's seen my father in the film, so he's very critical to the film.
Cool.
And I'm saying, I'm missing the stage. Yeah, I've been on the stage for 3.5 years now. So yeah, I'll be back on stage soon. So thank you.
Okay, everybody. Another question for you. Yeah. So basically, the film is called Hum Bhi Akele, Tum Bhi Akele. Yeah. It sounds like a very sad title. Like, why is it such a... I mean, it's sounding very lonely. The loneliness is written in the title, but it's not in the film. So why this particular title?
So, two reasons. When I pick up a film, which we produced as well at the company, balance, I look at it as a very poetry. Imagined it. Because, see, we're born in reality. And on the journey, we find companions, we find partners, we find friends. So the journey is about the journey, but eventually life is coming alone and going alone. So for me, the title was very poetic from that point of view. Also, the filmmaker Harish Rao is a very poetic person, and he likes poetry a lot. So I think our audience kind of matched on that level, and we stuck to the title. Also, I know I'm going to do a campaign right. So if you see the poster, if you see the trailer, there's a pep to it. But there is a strong undercurrent with the title that we think that no matter what happens in life, how happy you get, it should be that the penny drops one day. So make the most of it between those two flag posts. So that's why Hum Bhi Akele, Tum Bhi Akele. In a happy way. And I will want you all to look at it in a happy way, man. So that is a happy way.
And where was the film shot primarily? Since the audiences don't know yet, they have not watched the film, but I just want you to let us know how has been the shooting journey of this film.
We shot from Delhi, went drove up to Himachal, so Palampur, Dharamshala, Mikloidwa, and that's the journey of the film. We also shot in Meerut for one day and Chandigarh for one day. That is where you see in the film. That's where Veer and Mansi come from. So that's the shooting. And Himachal is just beautiful. Like, it's one of my favorite states. And I hope we are able to do to Himachal what we want to do and what Zindagi Na Milegi Dobara did to Spain. We start recollecting McLeodganj and Dharamshala with Amir.
And what about the songs? I mean, how many songs are there in the film? Can you hum one of the songs? Which is your favorite song in the film? And can you hum one of it?
मशहूर है तू दिल का नूर है तू फितूर है तू गुरूर है तू दिल का नूर है तू सुरूर है तू that's a song, that's my one of my favorite songs. मशहूर नजदीकियां has dropped today. बुल्ला की जाना मैं कौन is the famous Bulle Shah's poem about identity, about there's a Rabbi had done a rendition which we all love, but this is a new rock rendition. Oni Adil are the music composers and they've done a phenomenal job with the song. And there's Nadbikyam, which is the music of today, which is a very fresh love. And the last one is Hai Nahi, which is a bit of a ballroom sort of a classical. The album has a very interesting mix. Thank you, Rohini. I'm glad you like the love. So guys, please check out the album. These two are a talent. Oni Adil are the future. And I will be using them again from the live.
Okay. We're going to close very soon the conversation. But any word of advice for actors who are going to be playing gay characters, young actors who want to play gay characters, but they're very scared about playing it because they feel it's going to be typecasting them. Any advice from you?
Firstly, to drop this fear of typecast. There is nothing called typecast. If you're good enough, you will break the cast. And you will keep setting your own rule. Nobody don't start with on the back foot. Like, that's how I look at it. You need, if something excites you, do it the whole way. Be responsible to your clips. So do considerable research. And take feedback. And stay true to the script. And then trust your director. That's what I always do. I read the script, I trust my director, and I do severe research. And So I think if the prep is wrong, you never fear. I think only people who are, the root of insecurity is fear. So I think fear comes from lack of preparation. And if you prepare well, prepare hard, you have nothing to fear, you fly. And that's my only advice for any role, not just for coach. Because the moment I specifically say something for this, I am myself distinguishing, which I don't want to. It's a challenge like any other well-written challenge.
All right. So thanks a lot for chatting up with us, Anshuman Jha, taking time out of your busy schedule with your release coming up. Everybody, please watch the Hum Bhi Akele, Tum Bhi Akele on Disney Hotstar from this Sunday, right?
This Sunday, 9th of May, Disney Plus Hotstar VIP. I promise you will have a smile on your face.
And please write your feedback on Kashish Handel or write to Anshuman Jha on Instagram. Please follow Kashish Film Fest. Instagram handle for more updates about Kashish 2021. Thanks a lot, Anshuman. Really happy to have you. Bye-bye. Take care.
Bye. You take care, sir. Please stay safe.
Thanks.